If you want to solve the whodunit concerning the MH17 shutdown on July 17th, 2014, and the murder on hundreds of innocent people and many children with teddy bears, then you have to follow the money, and it will always lead to Octagon in the Alps, just as it does this time. Follow the money trail, because all wars are geostrategical wars about financial profits. The Crusaders were so when Switzerland of the Templars became filthy rich, hiding Pharaoh's Templars' treasure in the caves of Octagon. Even more Swiss wealth through their pillaging Swiss Nazi Templars, bringing Europe's wealth to the Swiss Nazi banks in World War II. The Gulf Wars were and are about petrol, Afghanistan and Vietnam, Southeast Asia war about opium and the CIA cocaine imports agency, and so forth. Just as the 9/11 false flag ops, the sacrifice of hundreds of innocents on July 17th was only the preliminary to adjust people's mindsets and the world's public opinion, this time not against the Muslim world, but wrath towards Putin and Russia, in order to prepare the acceptance of a huge theft and robbery by the enemy within of the fair aristocracy and their Swiss base, always parasiting on the world, becoming clear 11 days later on July 28, 2014, in the very same country where most of the victims came from, and being the reason that the victims were chosen to die because of their nationality. Because 11 days later, the tremendous UCOS trial took place in The Hague, in the very same country where all the victims came from, leaving an intense concentration of national anger, naturally more intense, even more intense than the international feelings towards Russia. There you go. It says the date, yeah, July 28th, just 11 days after the downing of the airliner on July 17th. A court in the Netherlands, in The Hague, and they wanted 100 billion even. It's always about money. Just as 9/11 was about oil and big time money. And it's always Switzerland behind it. And it was in this intense atmosphere of anger towards Russia and general outcry to settle the score, definitely influencing the verdict, condemning Russia to a sentence of more than $51 billion, which under the given circumstances cannot be accepted as a fair trial and should therefore be annihilated. Let's follow the money trail, or shall we say the blood trail, a little more. Who gets the money? The shareholders of UCOS do, who are undoubtedly in Switzerland, just as the UCOS owner Mikhail Khodorkovsky is Swiss-based, together with the rest of the Russian oligarchs. Yes, all huge crimes against humanity lead to Switzerland. The Swissies always have their dirty little fingers in it, somehow. So here you can see, this is Russia, this is the map of Russia. And this is like a vampire, Dracula, UCOS. So, benefiting from Russia, it's going down the cliff here. And this, of course, is Khodorkovsky. And you see the pyramid in there, in the UCOS logo, the V symbol of the Templars, in three parts for Isis, Horus and Seth. This pharaonic Swiss-based Khodorkovsky, you know, they're bloodsuckers, just as the picture shows. As I've showed you before in my videos about Khodorkovsky, the moment this guy was released from prison on December 20th, 2013, all hell broke loose in the world, with only 1 week later, on December the 29th, 2013, the Volgograd attacks, then in February 2014, the Ukrainian Revolution, and now a war. June 12, 2014, three Israeli kids murdered, followed by a war, with of course the legacy of Swiss grey eminence François Genoux by his present day next Swiss emissaries acting in the Middle East. And all the time Switzerland and their huge fascist financing industries are behind it somewhere. And here another video on my other channel called Pharaoh Oligarchy about Khodorkovsky in Switzerland, and then there are some more videos, so I don't have to repeat it all. Khodorkovsky lives in Rapperswil near Zurich now. Why that town? Is there a reason or a connection to Russia there? Well, there must be a reason, because these guys do nothing uncalculated. Sir? Well, in fact there is, because they have an anti-Russian tradition there, connected to the fair aristocracy in the castle of the Counts of Rapperswil, where there is a Polish museum linked to the Polish Count Platter and his fight against Russia, just as Mr. Khodorkovsky himself. Put in the links for you, of course. There it is in English. There's his house, and yeah, just read it. It's interesting, you know. You know, the Swiss, he gets treated as a hero, welcomed as a hero. You know, he's eating pizza together with the mayor, Erich Zoller, and discussing the plans, the financial plans and all that. Another one brought him a bottle of vodka. Vodka. How do you like my pronunciation? Well, these are the type of immigrants Switzerland likes, you know, who bring money, with whom we can pillage the world. Not those blackies without any money, you know, come from Africa. Well, those ones, we need to give them Ebola so we can, you know, lock down the borders. See my last video on that. Oh, that's Switzerland, eh? So here's some more intel on Wikipedia about Rapperswil. That's, you see the roses, that's a coat of arms. They call it the town of roses. Like the Rosicrucians, right? Here's the history. Already the Romans were there. And in 165 AD, and this is interesting about the Counts of Rapperswil and the Rapperswil Castle. For Mr. Khodorkovsky, it's like coming home. He's being treated as a hero in Switzerland because he pillaged Russia for Switzerland, for the motherland. This is a Swiss sleeper agent. Oh, you bet he is. He looks like an aristocrat anyway, and he is. And they always have this base Switzerland. Rapperswil. Wil, it's a Latin word, like vil or villa, it means a town. And I guess rappers have nothing to do with any rappers or Little John or whatever his name is. So here's the castle of Rapperswil, where there's a museum and where they have been fostering anti-Russian sentiments for ages. I mean, it's in the culture probably. And that's why Mr. Khodorkovsky chose Rapperswil. And that's one of the reasons. And he's probably a descendant of the barons of Rapperswil, it says. And here's Vladislav Brol Platter, another count. It's all the aristocracy, just as Mr. Khodorkovsky himself. He's a descendant, okay, he grew up as a poor man in Moscow and all that. But he has the blood in his veins. Probably some ancestor married a some poor but beautiful Russian girl, like, you know. And he's coming back as a knight, you know, like from the Crusades. Like after having pillaged Russia. You understand what I mean? And they did MH17. I have no doubt. It's all leading to Switzerland again, and again, and again. So, here's the Polish Museum in Rapperswil, inside the castle. Well, not anyone can just, you know, put an exhibition in a castle just like that. You have to be part of the gang, you know? Well, and they are. This is the Polish aristocracy who have a grunt against Russia. So, here in the town of the Rappers, there's a connection to Russia. That's why he chose it. And I mean, look at this guy here. Well, he looks like Khodorkovsky to my concern. So that's why he's... So they got their revenge on Russia, you know, the aristocracy did here. $51 billion. And the war in the Ukraine and... this oil company. So it's all the it's the aristocracy again, you know. So you can read it yourself. It's all backed up by Switzerland, and they love money in Switzerland. Oh yeah, here's again the Rapperswil Castle. They love money in Switzerland. Then you get treated very, very well. If a poor Russian or a poor Polish guy or something comes to Switzerland, oh man, they'd love to put him in the slammer, you know. Oh, he's Polish, so he comes here to steal or something. That's what they think. But if it's an aristocrat and if he's rich, it says the Polish count Vladislav Blatter, you know, here's the connection. And to the Yukos oil, it's all about revenge. And all those young children with their teddy bears had to die for this. So here's some more about the Rapperswil and the castle. So on the Count of Rapperswil, he went into the Crusades. Well, not only this one. So, I mean, who was giving the orders anyway in the Crusades? Well, it was the aristocracy, of course. Stealing things, killing 30,000 people in Jerusalem. They've always been killing and cheating and murdering and pillaging, haven't they? Yeah. And here's the Count Ladislaus Platter. He's Polish. Well, of course, he's not Polish. It's a pharaoh. The aristocracy, they're all pharaohs. Well, look at the video, my video, Pharistocracy. And Mr. Khodorkovsky is one of them. He's the biggest hero at the moment. And Putin is one of them as well. What do you think? So here's a zoomed in map of Switzerland. Here's Zurich, the financial center. Hey, Mr. Khodorkovsky. Here's Rapperswil. And here's Schwyz, where the name Switzerland or Switzerland is coming from. And the Switzers is the name for the Swiss mercs.
who are also in South Africa, of course. This is where we are living, in Bern. Yeah. So it's all mixed together. Here they founded Switzerland, around here. And here's Rapperswil. It's all, it's the same place, eh?
So Khodorkovsky, undoubtedly a long-term Swiss sleeper agent of that Swiss fifth column of many generations, not only came back to the motherland, where he dumped all the stolen money from the Russian people, but he even settles down in that very place with a specific lineage. And the Swiss sleeper agents are really a real thing. Just watch these videos here, especially this one here, and here, and here, and there are many more. Yeah, Swiss, even Swiss sleeper agents in the US. It's real, the proofs are there. It's very, very real. We can see it happening. Just look at the Fahrtscher symbol of the canton in which Rapperswil is in. This is St. Gallen, and this is the canton, where the canton is a Latin name for a corner, a place, an area, where Rapperswil, where Mr. Khodorkovsky lives, where it's in. This is the Fahrtschers with an X here. Yeah, Switzerland, the Templars flag. And this is where the word fascism is from, which was, which is from Switzerland anyway. They financed Adolf Hitler. Even Mussolini spent some time in Switzerland. That's where it's from. Switzerland, Octagon. What do you want more? And it shows as well in the American, the US Senate, and everywhere, all over. And here's a badge of the police of St. Gallen, with the fascists, and anyone who comes, like anyone who comes near to Mr. Khodorkovsky, well, we chop his head off, you know. And the Fahrtschers, actually, it means the same thing like the Freemason proverb, all for one and one for all, which says, in fact, at the ceiling of the Swiss Parliament in Latin, pro omnibus omnen, or something like that. Well, I filmed it somewhere. It means all these are branches, and one branch, you know, you can break it, but these branches are tied together like in an organization. You can't break them. They're all like protecting each other's backs. That's what these criminals do, you know. It's like a conglomerate, it is. So this is Mr. Khodorkovsky, his police, you know. He's giving the orders and his pals. And these are the Octagon hounds of the aristocracy. The ones who come here and put three guns in my head. So the Fahrtschers, where the word fascism is from, is a Nazi symbol. It's the basics of Nazism. And this is what the Swiss police are having on their badges. Because they are Nazis. This is the Swiss Gestapo. A bunch of liars, crooks, criminals, racists, plain Nazis. And working together with the Swiss Justice Department, who are also a bunch of Nazis. Very extremely dangerous. And the Yukos Pyramid logo divided into three parts for Isis, Horus and Seth, even showing the Templar's V and a golden capstone. Here's the golden capstone, here's the V of the Templars, and well, that's Isis, Horus and Seth. It's always, if you see three things, you know, it's Isis, Horus and Seth. Or the which stands in fact also for the Holy Spirit, the Father and the Son. The Son of course is Horus, the Holy Spirit is Isis, the idea, and the Horus matrix, and the Father of course is Seth, or in some cases you could say Osiris, who is his real father, but the father of the idea, what it's about, is Seth, or Sethon, which is Satan, yeah?
So this is Yukos. They're pharaohs. It's the aristocracy, because the pharaohs became the aristocracy in the old world's order, and they became the new world's order with the Freemasons. It's all the same. They never left. And they're killing people. They're lying. They're cheating. They're torturing people. They're doing satanic rituals, black magic, etc., etc. Wars without end. We got thousands of years of wars. There's no end to it with their pyramids. Here's Yukos on Wikipedia. I can even tell you why they chose the name, why they gave it the name Yukos. That's a long story anyway. I put in the links for you. So now they got 51 billion. Well, they haven't got it yet. But, let's put in the links. Well, our man Khodorkovsky here is definitely a descendant of the nobility and coming back to the castle of his predecessors. By the way, the Count of Rapperswil also attended the Crusades together with many others of the Swiss nobility, butchering 30,000 people in Jerusalem in 1099, walking knee-deep in rivers of blood, definitely the work of those genocidal Swiss slipthroats. I mean, who gave the orders in the Crusades? Well, the nobility, of course. Who else? And they are of pure pharaonic lineage, doing big business today, owning everything and still parasiting on us, as in the feudal days, as our Mr. Khodorkovsky here. So this here is about the Swiss nobility. There's a lot, eh? So these are only some families, you know, that how many are there? And they love their hero, Mr. Khodorkovsky. Here it says, the Rapperswilers. Oh, charming, isn't it? Buying Mr. Khodorkovsky a vodka. Now, why do you think President Putin let him out on a presidential amnesty, this enemy of Russia? Well, Putin gets a cut, of course, and he only won the trust of the Russians in order to fulfill big theft. Hitler did the very same thing with the Germans. They always do this. This is pharaonic, our masters. The aristocracy always owned everything, and they still do. There he is, Prince Putin. Prince Putin with a Templar's cross and some octagons on his breast. See the film Octagon, the Empire of Darkness. If there are any Christians on the lookout for the Antichrist, Khodorkovsky scores quite high on the possibility index. Switzerland is like an aircraft carrier launching attacks on humanity, and in this case Russia, just as Vladimir Lenin spent years in Switzerland, from Geneva, Bern, Basel to Zurich, no doubt visiting the Rapperswil castle and its nobility, whose male lineage died out, by the way, probably leaning the way to the foundation of the damned place of Suisse, Sœurs d'Isis, or Sisters of Isis, for Switzerland. The German leaders, said Winston Churchill, turned upon Russia the most grisly of all weapons. They transported Lenin in a sealed truck like a plague bacillus from Switzerland into Russia. And he should know, because he's part of the aristocracy as well. And when his time came in 1917, Mr. Lenin suddenly left the aircraft carrier to launch a devastating attack on Russia through the Red Terror, murdering up to 1 million people, mostly army deserters and peasants, who revolted, not even mentioning the consequence Holodomor later on. And all this became possible because of that base of evil in the Alps. So Lenin, he said, so this is a man who spent a lot of time in Switzerland talking to people, getting orders, being taught by Octagon, He said, hang the kulaks, the peasant farmers, execute the hostages, do it in such a way that people for hundreds of miles around will see and tremble. Well, this is the Swiss way, and they do it today, you know, with all their pictures, you know, against foreigners in the streets, and, you know, so people will see it in hundreds of miles around and tremble. And in fact, all these guys here are related to the Swiss aircraft carrier, Octogon. The first one here, he got financed by the Swiss general Ulrich Wille from 1923 on. The second one here has Swiss ancestors from the canton of Bern in Ried, Kerzers. And this one here spent many, many years in Switzerland, where he got taught how to oppress the Russian people. The Swiss always got their dirty little fingers in it, everywhere and always, believe me. Here's some more about Mr. Lenin in Switzerland. Always Switzerland, Hitler, Obama, and now Khodorkovsky, Lenin. It's always related to this damn place. So he spent very many years in Switzerland. Well, he spoke German and he spoke French. And without any doubts, he even spoke the mother tongue, Swiss German. Just as the dictator from Korea and other Swiss sleeper agents. They're all Swiss sleeper agents. Mr. Lenin was one from the beginning, just as Eisenhower, Hoover, Herbert Hoover, Gay Edgar Hoover, General Custer, all of them. So here's some more. He spent 6.5 years total in Switzerland. Whoa, that's a long time, eh? To prepare oneself and go to Rapperswil Castle and talk to the aristocracy. And etc. etc. to punish the Russian people for their revolution. Just like the Ukrainian revolution, it was by the people in the beginning, and then the other ones, they just took over, like always in everything. They did it with the Christianity, they did it with even National Socialism, which was something from the people, you know, to feed the German people, but it became something very bad and evil, and even against the German people. And the real National Socialists in the Night of the Long Knives, they all got murdered by the ones who took control over it, and it became a very elitist organization. There was nothing anymore from the people. It was all aristocrats, von this, von, which is a German, you know, the German aristocracy, the old von, the vons, you know. Well, here's some more of what he said, you know, it's, you know, killing people, genocide, you know. I recognize the Swiss way of thinking in here, definitely. And there it is again. The best way to control the opposition is to lead it ourselves. So they know there's a need for revolution and change and bread in Russia. So then they send their man to Switzerland. He gets taught by Octogon. And then they send the bomb back, as Mr. Churchill said. I'm very sorry, I just saw here Jewish Bolshevik dictator. I didn't see that before. Excuse me. I wouldn't have used it otherwise, but of course he's not Jewish. I mean, the Jews, apparently, they're all over the world, but they're not the only ones. The aristocrats are as well. Everywhere and everywhere in the world are emperors and kings and tsars and whatever, princes and princesses and counts. They are everywhere. This is the aristocracy. So excuse me, I just leave it here like that, because So I could just tell you that it's... I mean, I don't give a rat's arse about any Jews. I mean, I'm not one of them, you know. But I don't want you to miss the real enemy. And don't blame the wrong ones for it, you know. So here's some intel about the Red Terror, and only made possible because of Switzerland, where Mr. Lenin went to, where they taught him, where they organized the aircraft carrier against humanity, where all the NGOs are pretending to be in favor of us, like the Red, the Nazi Red Cross and all that, you know. Well, I show you a nice one about the Nazi Red Cross, just a minute. Well, here's your Red Cross with a swastika on it as well, and a stupid bird. And here's the octagon of the Templars, of the Nazi Templars, what I've been telling you, from Switzerland. And here's another one on YouTube. It says Rotes Kreuz, it means the Red Cross. Here it is with a swastika. And this, it's almost like a fascist symbol. This is the Edelweiss. It's this flower which only grows in the Alps. Well, what do you know? And here's about Lenin on Wikipedia and his time in Switzerland. I put in the link, I'll keep it short here. And all wars, in fact, are wars of the nobility because of internal strife. As the old world order, like the Tsars and the French king, not willing to accept the new world order by the Templars, also of aristocratic and pharaonic descent, see my video Pharistocracy on Hatzefratz. The kings, tsars and emperors in power then didn't want to give up the old pharaonic ways of royal heritage in the monarchy to the new world order, a new system of the Templars in which every single one of them could stand equal chances to reign within that democratic dictatorship led by Freemasonry. So believe me, Putin is also one of them. Otherwise you cannot possibly become president. Out of the question. It says in Wikipedia, the loss of nobility did not exist in Switzerland, where the social classes were closer than in other countries. So they never had any problems, no revolutions, and they're still there. The nobility never, you know, there's no loss of nobility. Nobility. Yeah, Swiss nobility. Everywhere. Bloody pharaohs. Well, that's why they call it, here it is. Rapperswil. Yeah. Chodorkovsky. So this is Switzerland. They're selling the cakes in the form of a pyramid. This is Pharaoh country here. Look. Even the cakes look like a pyramid, like on the dollar. Probably 13 pieces of bricks here. This is Suisse, Sur Dizis. But it's in the town of Thun. What was the dragon? Show you the dragon. Yeah, look at the lizard. Just on where the shop is with the pyramid. Nice, eh? Whoa! As I showed you in Zurich. So this is the land of the bear, like in Black Water and the Revelations of John. So there's the cookie shop with the pyramid. There it is. The Counts of Rapperswil belong to the high nobility, the upper nobility, related to the House of Habsburg, where the name for a royal house in Pharaonic is Per, as in Per A, meaning the big royal house or lineage
where the word Pharaoh comes from. And also Rome was already there in Rapperswil in 165 AD. So there again, in Rapperswil, you find the Rome connection with Switzerland as the Vatican Guard, the Pope's Guard. They will probably send the Octagon police hounds of the Fair Aristocracy or Swiss Gestapo after me to come and haul me up after this video. And in fact, every nobleman knows about the things I'm telling you, but they would never reveal it to any simpleman, whom they regard to as peasants and subjects. So the downing of that MH17 airplane was ordered out of Switzerland, as always, and probably executed by some blind rage Chechens for them. That is, if there was an airplane and a missile at all, because the footprint of the crash site is too shallow, the engine props far too small, the corpses probably dumped there out of a cooler, the same plane from the same Malaysian Airlines with the same serial number had already disappeared a few months earlier over the Pacific, and if an airplane falls at 33,000 feet, the various parts will be scattered in a radius up to 10 miles. But real people have vanished, just as the passengers of 9/11 and the PSYOP and its effects are as real as it can get, so we might just as well presume that the plane was shot down. Because in both scenarios it was a false flag, an attack on the Russian people in order to steal billions through that Swiss-based Yukos pyramid enterprise from the motherland in the Alps, for which children with teddy bears in their hands had to be sacrificed and die or simply disappear.